I was very intimidated by photography, f-stops and shutter speeds, but I was forced to take a class due to my design degree. I was introduced to what a camera can really do and what, you know, storytelling can do. In terms of my work, I'm really both in the fine art and the commercial world. At the end of the day, I'm a portrait photographer, and I love to put my unique spin on portraits. The image of the woman in the swimming pool really just reminds me of, you know, your classic broken dream. You've got the sun, you've got all, you know, your classic Hollywood, you know, the trees and the mountains in the distance, and then this empty pool and this dirty water, and the girl just mimicking the environment behind her. It just really sums up what a lot of people experience in California. I have built my platform in the commercial world of photography, shooting celebrities and musicians, but then I like to use that platform to do personal work overseas. So I've done a lot of work in Africa and Haiti, and I love to use that influence to tell stories that are bigger than me, bigger than anything I've done in the commercial world. The image of the man in the brown hat was from a series I did in Rwanda on reconciliation. I photographed people who had forgiven the killers of their family during the 94 genocide. And not only that, but I photographed them where the murder and the crimes happened. We went back to the scenes of the crime. I remember being in the moment and trying to nail the shot, technically speaking, but emotionally speaking. I'll just never forget that face and the moment and the story and the fact that he's forgiven, you know, the people that killed his family. When the print is right, when you nail it, you know, on the print, it's so much better than anything a screen can ever represent or show. And it's fun talking to new photographers in this digital age, because they're like, man, I printed, and I'm just so blown away. It's just so much more special to hold an image, to hold a print. But especially when you print the same image on four or five different types of paper, it just has a different quality, a different end result, a different feeling. You notice composition and light and color. You just see it differently. And sometimes it even affects editing. You know, sometimes I'll change an image based on the way it sits on a print. You know, there are certain images that I've shot overseas that belong on a certain type of paper, and then there's some of the more glossy commercial work I do that wouldn't work on that same type of paper, and you really just have to see it. And once again, it's one of those things you have to experience to understand. The prints really are my legacy. I want anything I do, whether it's commercial or fine art, to have longevity. It's so important to have more permanence, more light fastness, so I'm very thankful for the new Epson ink technologies. It's just a beautiful thing to document this world we live in, this one chance we get at life, and the idea that those photos and memories will live well beyond me. You can't beat that.